So back in Canaan, the future looked rough. Jacob's family were finding it tough.
For the famine has brought us unprepared. We are thin, we are ill, we are getting scared. It's enough to make anyone weep. We are down to our very last sheep.
We will starve if we hang around here.
But in Egypt, there's food going spare.
They've got corn, they've got meat,
they've got fruit and drinks.
And if we had the time, we could see the Sphinx!
So they finally decided to go off to Egypt to see Brother Joe. So they all lay before Joseph's feet.
Mighty prince, give us something to eat.
Joseph found it a strain not to laugh.
I dreamed that in the fields one day the corn gave me a sign. Your 11 sheaves of corn all turned and bowed to mine. I dreamed I saw 11 stars, the sun, the moon and sky, bowing down before my star. Now I realize why. How do I know where you come from? You could be spies telling me that you are hungry. That could be lies. How do I know who you are? Why do you think I should help you? Would you help me?
Yes!
Why on earth should I believe you? I've no guarantee.
Bravo, bravo, cringe bows to fall. Hope's almost gone. It's getting very hard to see us from sideways. Bravo, 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 bravo,
bravo. Rather like the way you're talking, astute and sincere. Suddenly your tragic story, it gets me right here.
This is what we
tugging at my heartstrings seems quite justified. I should give you what you came for and lots more beside.
Groveled with base gratitude.
Then unseen, Joseph whipped out around the back and planted a cup in young Benjamin's sack.